J-Cat. If there were ever a distinctive voice and a memorable personality that personifies the best, it would have to be Jake. A model for excellence for many a young, aspiring lead singer, an example of perseverance to many road-weary veterans, Jake has also been a gracious gentleman, a loyal friend, and a devoted husband and father. Recently, we visited with Jake and Joyce in their home and talked with their grown children around the family table and ended up looking through some albums of Hess family memories.
And this is the early Hess family.
Mm-hmm. Was it
like the 60s?
Cat there.
he was destined to be a star.
That's right.
Look at him. Chris, no tacky dress.
But you notice who has the biggest ears in the picture now. Big move.
The ears. <please.
laughs> How'd you two meet?
At a singing.
Right.
So I spared her all this trouble for a long time. I'd seen her around for 5 or 6 years. But I never did have enough nerve to ask her for a date. So one night I came home and I went to Gadsden, Alabama, or Atala, Alabama, to see Miss Mackwaters. And that night I proposed to her, and she laughed at me. So I just went downtown, checked in the hotel, and came back the next night.
Proposed to her again. Yeah, but tell them what you asked, well, how you asked.
The first night I asked, would she like to be buried with my people?
She said no.
I said no.
And so I thought maybe I better stay over and let her know I was really serious about that thing.
I don't guess there would be a Jake Hess as we think we know him. I don't guess there'd be a Jake Hess had it not been for Hovey Lister.
Yeah.
Hovey did a lot for me.
Yeah, he did.
You know, Jake, the first time I ever heard Denver with a group was in the Ryman Auditorium in Nashville. And you didn't know very many songs. You had rehearsed that weekend. You went out to sing the few that you did know. But what you did know, you sang a lot.
And you had just learned the old landmark. And my dad will still remind me of, you suppose Hovey and Jake still sing the old landmark? And that's one of the songs that you put on the Nabisco show. Right. That was so much fun. And Hovey sings with you. And you rascals, you really got serious on that tune, didn't you?
Oh, we love that song. That song is one of those that, there's a real feel, there's a certain feel to some of those spirituals that, even more so than the other ones. You can rehearse them all night and it's just not there, but you sang Old Landmark one time, you loved it.
Well, let us all go back to the old landmark. Well, let us all go back to the old landmark. Well, let us all go back to the old landmark. Let us stay in the service of the Lord. Well, let us kneel and pray in the old time way. Well, let us kneel and pray in the old time way. Well, let us kneel and pray in the old time way. He will and he will be great from till the of his. It will save this over from sin and shame.
Well, I want to see a big revival in the old time way.
Big revival
in the old time way.
Big revival
in the old time way.
Sinner,
hurting,
unbirthed,
joining,
rich, and
dirty,
burning.
He will,
heroes,
and be,
heroes,
it will,
wonder,
it will,
turn this,
it will,
save
it
over from sin and shame.
Well, let us all
go back
to the old landmark. Well, let us
all go
back to the old landmark. Well, let us
all go
back to the old landmark.
Let us stay in the service of the Lord.
Well, come on down
to the river
in the old
time way.
Well, let us go
down
to the river in the old
time way.
Well, come on
down to the river
in the old
time way.
When was your first big bout with all the different physical ailments? Did you have that open heart surgery? Was that the first big problem you had?
No, 62 was
1962, February.
Nephritis. That was my first endeavor in all these isms. And, of course, then I had a heart attack. First heart attack was in 1968, wasn't it, honey?
Uh-huh.
And then the first...
Was it open heart surgery then after that?
The 72 open heart 72. Surgery.
And the next one was 86.
Right.
And I've had a few cancer operations, septicemia, and some of those things in between. And had to get all that through so I could get diabetes and pet that a little.
You know, there's something to be said for being raised in a Christian home and a Christian mom and dad. But, you know, I can always get in a bind, and I always want to talk to my dad. I always want him there, and he can always tell me it's going to be okay. And somehow it is okay after he says that. I'm nearly 40 years old, and, you know, just a few months ago, I nearly lost this baby. And we got Mother in Columbus, and I told her, I said, I want you to find my daddy. And I think he was with you.
Yeah.
I said, I want you to find my daddy, and I want him to pray, and I want him to be here, and I know everything will be okay. And he went through that, you know, it's going to be okay, and, you know, and how everything was in God's hands, and, you know, what you're talking about.
Someday when I breathe my final breath, and the doctor takes one look and says, you're dead. The truth is gonna finally be revealed. Oh, I'm gonna find death ain't no big deal. He reached down and gently closed my eyes. I'll be watching from the other side.
Other side.
I'll be laughing about how scared I thought I'd feel. Oh, I'm gonna find it ain't no big deal. My soul is gonna be just like a bird set free. I'll sail right past the moon up to the stars. And I know I'll be amazed when I get to heaven's gate, 'cause I knew my way home by heart. The light will shine much brighter than the sun, and I'll be right back where I started from.
Started from.
Ain't no way to say how good I'll feel. Oh, I tell you, children, it ain't no big deal.
My soul is gonna be just like a bird set free.
I'll sail right past the moon up to the stars.
To the sky.
And I know I'll be amazed when I get to heaven's gate, 'cause I knew my way home by heart. A light will shine much brighter than the sun, and I'll be right back where I started from.
Started from.
Ain't no way to say how good I'll feel. Oh, I tell you, children, it ain't no big deal.
And by Maker's feet I'm gonna be.
Thank you, Lord. Death ain't no big deal.